chasing it. This is a shot intended to play. That's well fielded.
Run out. Well, not for the first time. A terrible mix-up between Miendad and Imzamam.
There.
Miendad stroked it out into the covers, and he was running as he played the shot. It was to the left of the fielder. He picked it up left-handed. He had all the time in the world to whip it in over the top of the stumps to the wicketkeeper. And Imzamam is the man who will have to leave. You see, it's to his left hand. He's got lots of time to turn and just lob it in quietly. Miendad has gone all the way to the other end, and look at, on the right of your picture, Imzamam stranded halfway.
And that picture showed a total breakdown of communication between the two. There. Not a wicket Pakistan could afford to lose.
And this is how it happened.
Miendad takes off. There's no response from Imzamam. I think there was no calling either. And we don't have Imzamam in the frame yet. He was a little
park. There's Johnson, Pakistan.
Now there might be trouble here. Is he run out? Imzamam has been run out once before in the series. And I think he's gone here again.
It was his call, but he got sent back. And as we've just said, he's a big fellow. He couldn't turn quickly enough. Dave Richardson struggling to get the wicket in time. Dives a la Jonty Rhodes. No doubt about that whatsoever.
There's the red light. And Imzamam is on his way. And what a valuable wicket for South Africa to get. Again, some splendid fielding. And for the second time in the series, he has been run out. This time for 10. And it's 39 for 2. Good work by Dave Richardson. The third umpire, Attar Saeed, had an easy decision to make there. The coverage was good too.
Oh, there's trouble here. There's a run out on here. Yeah. Oh, dear. Imzamam wanted the run. Hamid didn't. Hamid lost. The third wicket goes down. Well, Imzamam is quite correct. It was his call. He was running to the danger end. I don't know why Yasser Hamid wasn't running. Imzamam called early. It was Ashish Nehra, who's not a great fielder. He fumbled it. If Hamid had run as soon as he was called, he was home easily. So you cannot blame Imzamam for this. It's his call, behind point. Hamid only has himself to blame. And he's missed out on 100. 225 for 3.
No.
Oh, gone. I mean, that is just ridiculous. We've been talking about Inzamam's lack of ability running between the wickets. Well, Ejaz has gone, and I can only assume that was just a complete lack of communication between the two of them. This is horrific stuff.
Imzamam pretends to run, then stops in the midfield, and Ejaz nowhere near his ground. Very silly piece of cricket.
Ejaz gone, run out by Chris Harris for 51, 163 for 4. The new batsman is Salim Malik.
Close with a hit and outs. My word, what a stupid piece of cricket, but great fielding and thinking by Jack Russell. That really was a foolish bit of cricket, because Sohail went to what he thought was the danger end and got home, but Russell, spotting that the other man, Imzamam, was in trouble, immediately went for the baseball equivalent of a double play and pulled it off. Terrific out cricket there.
This time it goes straight. That could be four more. Didn't quite time it. Bevan will pick it up. Wasn't Akram coming back for the third? Oh, yes. They're running out here, surely? No, he's safely back, I think. No. Out! He's gone! It's too slow. I'm sure he's gone. Wasim Akram took a long time to go back and put the bat down. What a tragedy for Pakistan if he's a judge run out. I'm sure he is. The call for the third umpire, Bill Sheen. Good direct throw, hit the stumps, and the captain was mucking around, and I think has paid the full penalty.
Well, Wasim Akram has been trying to get into Manul Haq to be a bit quicker with his running, and this is going to be very, very close. Well, the bills are in the air, and the bat is in the air. That's out, as far as I'm concerned.
Let's have a look where the bails are. He's gone. Farley makes a decision. And that's a tragedy for Pakistan. It was poor running. You must ground your bat before the line. And Wasim Akram has paid the penalty.
It's 6 for 9.
Small ball, and he picked it. May go for 2. It's Reid. He's coming back. This will be very close. He's got to go. No, the throw was high. He's got him. Yes, he's got him. Oh, he seemed to be making ground. The throw seemed to be wide. But the decision is out. He looked out and he was making the run, but the throw was high, and here we had to drag the ball back into the stumps.
He's not the quickest man to the ball, Bruce Reid, but he has got a strong throwing arm, and he wasn't that far from the stumps. It was only a throw of about 50 metres, but no wonder In Zamam has given the umpire the glare. He was well and truly home.
There's no way he can give him out there. Oh, and that's got
him!
He's gone this time! He's got him! In Zamam out! Al-Haq is outrun out! They have tried it once too often, and I tell you what, the Kiwis are all out of their seats. On the ground, they've all gathered around. This man has played a magnificent innings. It's all come to the end. And he's just wondering now as he wanders back to the pavilion whether he's taking Pakistan's World Cup chances with him.
Well, he's scored 60 and 37 deliveries. Well, it's that man Harris again, and he doesn't miss. He's been absolutely superb in the field. So Pakistan, 227 for 5.
Chance for a run out if he hits. Into the wall, up in the air to go to the third umpire. Bevan got him, a direct hit. Amazing how run outs can change matches. In Zamam looks well, nonplussed at the moment, but well, it's all happening here.
It's Yuvraj Singh, a direct hit now. In Zamam will have caught napping. I think he's gone. This is a major, major breakthrough. What was he thinking? Didn't run hard. Yuvraj Singh seized the opportunity, knew exactly which end to throw. And I think he's gone.
That angle's a good angle there to see that's hit the stumps on the way through. Here it is here. It's hit the stumps before it's hit the gloves. The gloves haven't knocked the bails off, and he's just short of his ground by 6 to 10 inches there. And they've lost the skipper. Can you believe it?
It's all been paradise. That's out. That's out. In Zamam is gone. Looking for a quick single. Couldn't turn back. The whole crowd's just gone stunned there.
Well, what's he done here? In Zamam. He's gone and run himself out. Just... three short of the third successive Test match 100. I don't think he was even looking at the field. It was the England captain, Michael Vaughan, who fielded the ball. Look at In Zamam charging down the pitch. Direct hit from Vaughan. Runs his opposite number out. In Zamam run out for 97. And he's immediately declared the Pakistan innings.
Quick single, that's always going to be dangerous, a direct hit, and umpire Dave Shepherd has called for the third umpire, Doug Cowherty, to get involved. Jonty Rhodes, I can't believe they looked for a single to Jonty Rhodes. And you can always tell from the reaction of one of the two teams out there, the batters, they either stand around and look quite comfortable, the fielders get very excited, and South Africa, I must say, look quite excited.
Good pickup by Jonty Rhodes, firing it in. And Zamam shot at this point of time, but not being dragged, could be in the air. that's again a pretty silly cricket from Inzamam.
Well, the South African players are celebrating. They know the result of this. I'm not sure why Doug Cowie hasn't pressed the appropriate button, but unbelievable there. And it is to see that the bat wasn't grounded.
Yes, Inzamam not doing the basis. I mean, that you learn in school cricket. Late there. And South Africans now again picking up the wicket.
Well, had he grounded the bat before the line, he would have been safe, I think. But look at that. The bat hits the ground. Very late, about a metre behind the line. It's well in the air now. It only hits the ground now. The bails are off. And the third umpire has done his job. So Inzamam has been given out. And surprise, surprise, run out.
Well, the sordid saga continues. Inzamam once again perishing to reckless running. Well, they called early, but then again forgot to do the basics.
Imagine the coach is not going to be too impressed with this. Another look at the run out. Jonty Rhodes, two hands, good pickup, good balance there, and a direct hit was always going to be in problems. And look at that, hits the stumps, and the bat is not grounded. Had it been grounded, he would have been safely home. Quite remarkable. So Inzamam goes for four.
They'll have to hurry. Yes. Inzamam will hug his thrown out. That was an absolutely splendid throw. Richie Richardson hitting the stumps, and umpire Steve Butner took time, but it looked the correct decision.
That was good work there. Coming in quickly from the mid-wicket position, Richie Richardson. Let's have a look here. Definitely out of his crease there.
108 for 3.